In today's session, we are going to learn about critical angle and total internal reflection. Now, we have the figure here. So, first of all, I would like to ask you a question. What do you mean by an optically rarer medium? What do you mean by an optically rarer medium? It has nothing to do with the mass density. So, the concept of denser and rarer is relative, and that depends on where the speed is greater. So, in a rarer medium, speed is greater. And when it comes to optically denser medium, what we will say is that speed is lesser. In an optically denser medium, light travels with a lesser speed or smaller speed. In an optically rarer medium, light travels with a greater speed. Whereas in an optically denser medium, light travels with a smaller speed. When it comes to light, air is a rarer medium and glass is a denser medium. When it comes to sound, if you consider about a wave, where the speed is greater, that is a rarer medium. Where the speed is lesser, that is a denser medium. So let me come to this point. So optically rarer medium, in that case, the speed of light is greater. And optically denser medium is that medium where the speed of light is smaller. So this is one idea you have to understand regarding optically denser and optically rarer mediums. Let me tell you. Now here, I am considering the interface XY of two media having refractive indices N1 and N2. As it is, as you can see here, N1 is greater than N2. N1 greater than N2. Which means, the light is traveling from optically denser medium. So refractive index greater means, it is an optically denser medium. Greater the refractive index, smaller will be the speed of light in that medium. So here, 1 is an optically denser medium, 2 is optically rarer medium. And in this case, what you can see is that the light is traveling from an optically denser medium to an optically rarer medium. Light is traveling from optically denser medium to an optically rarer medium. Which means, as we know, so when it travels from an optically denser medium to an optically rarer medium, this angle is I. So it will bend away from the normal. So that is, this angle is R. Now what happens if I increase the angle of incidence further? Angle of refraction further increases. Again, if I increase the angle of incidence further, angle of refraction becomes 90 degrees. Now, in this case, this angle is called a critical angle. This angle is called a critical angle C. As you can see from the figure, so what is critical angle C represents? The angle of incidence. So critical angle may be defined likewise. Critical angle. What do you mean by critical angle? It is the angle of incidence. Evade? At the interface. At the interface of where? Denser to rarer medium. So angle of incidence at the interface of denser to rarer medium. For which angle of refraction, the angle of refraction is 90 degrees. So what is critical angle means? It is the angle of incidence, evade, at the interface of the denser to rarer medium, at the interface of the denser to rarer medium, for which the angle of refraction is 90 degree is called critical angle. the angle of incidence at the interface of the denser to rarer medium, for which the angle of refraction is 90 degree, is called critical angle. The angle of incidence at the interface of denser to rarer medium. Evade. Angle of incidence where? At the interface of. From where to where? From denser to rarer. What happens thereafter? For which the angle of refraction is 90 degrees called the critical angle. Now we will apply Snell's law to derive an expression for the critical angle. So here what you see is the angle of incidence I is equal to C. Angle of incidence I is equal to C. So applying Snell's law, sine C divided by, what is the value of angle of refraction? 90 degrees. So sine C divided by sine 90 is equal to, as it travels from medium 1 to medium 2, I will tell you N2 by N1. Or sine C is equal to, what is the answer we are getting? Sine C is equal to N2 by N1. This is the relation for the critical angle. The relation for critical angle sine C is equal to N2 divided by N1. What is N2? Refractive index of the rarer medium. So I can say sine C is equal to refractive index of rarer medium divided by refractive index. I will write RI. Refractive index RI. RI of rarer medium divided by RI of denser medium. So this formula will easily let you get all answers related to critical angle. So it is refractive index of the rarer medium divided by refractive index of the denser medium. This is the basic definition of critical angle. I hope this part is clear to you. Now let me tell you one more thing. The definition is, okay, due to the smaller size of the board, I am myself is supposed to wipe off it. If N1 is equal to 1, N, and N2 is equal to 1. In that situation, what is sine C is equal to? N2 is equal to 1, N1 is equal to N. In that case, sine C is equal to 1 by N. This is the answer you have to understand. Right. So this is the answer I can say. Sine C. C stands for critical angle here. Here C stands for critical angle. So this is an important relation you have to understand. So finally we conclude by stating this one. Okay. So sine C is equal to, now we will write it finally, sine C is equal to N2 divided by N1. This is V1 by V2. That is equal to lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 also. That we have studied in previous discussion, that N2 by N1 is equal to V1 by V2 is equal to lambda 1 by lambda 2. Now I can say if N1 is equal to 1, N2 is equal to 1 and N1 is equal to N. In that case, we will get sine C is equal to 1 by N. This is equal to 1, lambda medium divided by lambda air. That is velocity of the medium divided by C also. So this is another relation you have to understand for the critical angle. Once you get sine C, you will easily get the value of C. Yes. So this is idea regarding critical angle. Now the next question which I would like to ask you is, okay, suppose the angle of incidence here is C, the angle of refraction is 90 degree. What happens if the angle of incidence is greater than C? What happens if the angle of incidence I is greater than C? I is now greater than C. That is angle of incidence at the interface of the rare, denser to rarer medium is greater than 90 degree. In this case, my question is, What is going to be the angle of refraction? When I is equal to C, when I is equal to C, angle of refraction is 90 degree. What will happen when I is greater than C? According to our knowledge, sin R is proportional to sin I, right? That is what Snell's law says. So when angle of incidence increases, angle of refraction also must increase. When the angle of incidence is C, angle of refraction is 90 degree, which means when the angle of incidence is greater than C, angle of refraction must be greater than 90 degree, which means what happens? Greater than 90 degree means it will come back to this medium itself. Now, obviously, this angle also must be I. Okay, so it is coming back to the medium. Is it like reflection or refraction? One can say it is like reflection. So here, that reflection is what is called TIR, or otherwise we say total internal reflection. So, first word we got, why is it called internal reflection? Why is it called internal reflection? The answer is very simple. It is taking place only in this medium. So, it is called internal reflection. The second question, why is it called total internal reflection? Why is it called total internal reflection? It is called total internal reflection because there is no absorption of energy. There is no absorption of energy, or there is no absorption of light. There is no absorption of light. So that means 100% of the energy will be transmitted. That cannot be done by a mirror. Mirror cannot do that, because in mirror, what happens is that some of the light will be absorbed. So what I say is that if you feel like, okay, actually black is not a bad color. Black is, black is what is beauty. So what I'm coming to say is that if you feel some shy or anything regarding that, okay, so I'm black in complexity. Don't worry, you have to just understand that it is because mirror is absorbing light. That is the only reason why we feel black. I always admire that only. So that is what always I believe, that I am black only because mirror is absorbing some light. That is the reason why I am black. Really, I am black because mirror is absorbing some light. So actually, in total internal reflection, there is no absorption of light. In case of a mirror, it gives out only 95%, 90 to 95% of the incident light only. So around 5% of the light will be absorbed by that mirror. So no such absorption take place in case of TIR, otherwise we say total internal reflection. So the question which I am asking you is, what are the conditions for TIR? Conditions of TIR. First condition is, the angle of incidence should be greater than critical angle. Second condition, it should travel from denser to rarer. Light should travel from denser to rarer, and the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. These are the two essential conditions to be satisfied for total internal reflection. Now we will consider the applications of total internal reflection. Applications of total internal reflection. The first application I am going to take is regarding what is called a totally reflecting prisms. Totally reflecting prism. Yes. What is a totally reflecting prism? A totally reflecting prism is a right angled isosceles prism. A totally reflecting prism is a right-angled isosceles prism. So, first of all, let me tell you, the critical angle for glass is about to 42 degree. I think it is given as 41.14 degree. It's around 42 degree is the critical angle for glass. Now I said a totally reflecting prism is a right angled isosceles prism. Now let me draw such a prism. It's an isosceles prism. So this angle is 90 degree. What will be this angle? What will be this angle? What is the values of these angles going to be? This is 90 degree. What will be this angle? What will be this angle? Yes, tell me. Yeah, fine. This angle is going to be 45 degree. This angle also is going to be 45 degree, right? These two angles are 45 degrees respectively. So my question is, suppose if a light is incident like this. So here the angle of incidence is 0, angle of refraction 0. It will pass without any deviation. Angle of incidence. It is the angle made by the incident ray with the normal. Here normal and the incident ray are same. So angle of incidence is 0. So at this phase, at the phase AB, angle of incidence is equal to 0, angle of refraction also is equal to 0. Now, when it reaches the phase C, right, as you can see here, what is this angle? 45. This angle is also, this angle is 90 degree. This angle is 45 degree, right? Total angle, according to the angle sum property of the triangle, the sum of the angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. This is 45, 45 plus 45, 90, 90 plus 90 is equal to 180 degree. So this angle will become 45 degree. Question, is this angle greater than critical angle? Is this angle of incidence such this interface? This is refracting index n, this is refracting index 1, so it is traveling from. So two conditions, let us first of all to see, is the two conditions valid here? One, is the ray traveling from denser to rarer? Is the ray traveling from denser to rarer? I think the answer is yes. It is traveling from denser to rarer media. So angle of incidence is, so it is traveling from denser to rarer. The first condition for TAR is satisfied. Second condition, is the angle of incidence greater than critical angle? I think yes, because 45 is greater than 42 degree. Critical angle is 42 degree. And the angle mentioned here is 45 degree. That 45 degree is greater than the critical angle. So let me tell you, the angle of incidence here is 45 degree. It is traveling from denser to rarer medium. Intent to travel, that's the thing. Right, so obviously total internal reflection has to take place. That means the ray will undergo reflection, and this is also going to be 45 degree, because in total internal reflection, all the laws of reflection are valid. Now here the angle of incidence is 0, so it will come out likewise. The question which I am asking is, how much the incident ray is deviated here? So this is the direction of the incident ray, right? This is the direction of the incident ray. This is the direction of the emergent ray. Now which means the angle between the incident and the emergent rays is 90 degree. Angle between incident ray and the emergent ray is 90 degree. So this way, so this is the figure showing a totally reflecting prism. Rotates the incident ray by rotates the incident ray by 90 degree. This is the figure that shows where a totally reflecting prism rotates the incident ray by 90 degree. Ready? Now hope this is clear to you. So in the next discussion, so this is how an incident ray is rotated by 90 degree. Now let me take the next case. Okay, so here again I am considering a totally reflecting prism. But likewise. Okay, now take here. Suppose that an object is in front here. A man, say roughly saying, this is a, what I am saying, an imaginary concept only, a hypothetical one. So this is the incident ray from his head. This is incident like this. This is 45 degree. This is 45 degree. Obviously, as we have seen with the previous case, this angle also going to be 45 degree, right? This is 45, 90, which means the other angle is 45 degree. So what happens? Now this is rotated through 45 degree, right? This angle is 45 degree. Now again here, this is 90 degree, right? It's a right angled isosceles prism. 90 degree, this angle is 45 degree, 45 degree. Now this is going to be, this is 45 degree. And this is also going to be 45 degree. This is 45 degree. So angle of incidence here is greater than 42 degree. So it will undergo total internal reflection. And it will emerge like this. So this is where the light from the head is focused, is returned. Now here, just like the way I can say, this is from the foot. Now you can see that these two rays are parallel. Yes. Now this comes out like this. So that means his leg is here. Now my question is, what happened to the light here? So this is how I can explain a totally reflecting prism. Producing an inverted image. This is how a totally reflecting prism produces an inverted image of an erect object. This is an erect object. Now you are getting an inverted image of the erect object. And this way, what also you can see is that this is the direction of the incident ray. This is the direction of the emergent ray. So which means the incident ray now is rotated through 180 degree. This is the incident ray. This is the emergent ray. The angle between the incident and the emergent rays is 180 degree. So which means the ray is now rotated through 180 degree in the process. Ready? So it is rotated through 180 degree by a totally reflecting prism. I hope this idea is clear to you. A totally reflecting prism is used to rotate the incident ray by 180 degree. Okay. Now we will consider another application that is called a mirage. What is mirage? Mirage is an optical illusion caused by the difference in the relative refractive indices of air under hot conditions. This is the definition for mirage. You can see mirage is an optical illusion caused by the difference in relative refractive indices of air under hot conditions. Let me tell you, you have already seen this. Often we say it is seen in deserts, but you can see in our roads also. During hot conditions, actually, due to the relative difference in the refractive indices, it gives an illusion that water is present on roads. You might have seen it. You have experienced that watery effect in roads during hot conditions when you travel through a very straight road. Don't you? Just think about it. Now, here I am explaining this. During hot conditions, so we are considering a case of a desert. Let me say this is sand. As a result of the heat or hot conditions, the air closer to the sand will have more heat content compared to air above. The air closer to the sand will get heated more compared to what the air above. So as a result, what happens? If you take this layer, this is refractive index N1, N2, N3, so on. I can tell you N1 less than N2 less than N3 less than N4 because as a result of heating, the refractive indices of the air, layers of air will decrease. Now here, as you can see, the light is traveling from here. It is incident at the interface of denser to rarer medium. So it will bend away from the normal. Again, it is incident at the interface of denser to rarer medium. It again bends away from the normal. Again, it bends away from the normal. A stage comes when the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. In that case, what happens? It will undergo reflection, total internal reflection at this interface. It undergoes total internal reflection at this interface. Now, after reflection, it bends towards the normal. Now, this creates an illusion that the light is coming from here. Light is coming from here. So, that means he will be able to see the image of this object inside water. He will be able to see the image of this object inside this water. Able to see the image of this object inside water. What does that mean? So, sorry, the image of this object, not in water. I'm sorry, again, I have got that illusion. I'm sorry to say so. I got the same illusion, right? So, he will be able to see the image of this object just like it is present in water. Just like it is present in water. So, what this man feels like? Yes, there is water present. Is it actually there? No. So, when he reaches here, in Malayalam, we used to say he will become a sachi. Very simple. So, he won't find water here. So, that is the reason why I told you mirage is an optical illusion. It's an illusion. Mirage is an optical illusion created by the difference in the relative refractive indices of different layers of air. Ready. So, it's an important thing. The opposite. So, this is seen under hot conditions. The opposite of mirage is what is seen as looming. And this is seen under cold conditions. So, this is seen under hot conditions, but looming is the converse of the same. In that case, these layers will have greater refractive index because this is cold. So, refractive index decreases with the heating and it increases with the cooling. So, this will be more colder. This will be colder, I'm sorry. Colder, so greater refractive index. As we go upwards, the refractive index decreases. So, the opposite effect of mirage is what is called a looming. Okay. That is what I can say regarding mirage and looming. The next thing that we are going to discuss is regarding the circle of illuminance. Circle of illuminance. So, this is actually a new word for you. What do you mean by circle of illuminance? Let me tell you one thing. Consider a medium. And this is air. Okay. Now consider an object is present at a depth of D from the surface. Now the visibility of this object. Okay. Anyone looking from here can see this object. Anyone looking from here can see this object. Anyone looking from here cannot see this object. This angle is critical angle. And this light, if the angle becomes greater than critical angle, so what happens? This undergoes a reflection back to the medium. Now, anyone, the visibility of this object is limited for this angle C. That is critical angle. And similarly, if I take this side, this angle also is going to be C and this is 90 degree, right? The visibility of this object is now confined within this region. If you consider this aperture in three dimension, this is a circle. And so let me tell you, this circle is called the circle of illuminance. This is called the circle of illuminance. Circle of illuminance. So, what is the definition of circle of illuminance? It is that aperture, that circular aperture through which an object in the denser medium is visible. Or the visibility of the object is restricted through the circular aperture, and this is called the circle of illuminance. This circular aperture is called the circle of illuminance. Now I will make this figure a little more clear, so we will avoid what those things which are not required here. Now I am saying this angle is critical angle. Okay, fine. And its visibility is restricted to through the circle. Now this R is the radius of the circle of illuminance, and we need to get an expression for the radius of the circle of illuminance. Okay, ready. The refractive index of this medium is 1. The refractive index of this medium is okay, fine. So from the figure we know that sin C is equal to n2 by n1, that is 1 by n. So I'm going to draw a triangle. This is C. In that situation, opposite side is 1, this side is n, and this is root of n square minus 1, applying Pythagoras theorem. Now from the figure, what is tan C is equal to? Tan C, this radius is R, this depth is D. Tan C is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. Adjacent side is this length, that is D. Tan C is equal to R by D. Now looking at this triangle, what is tan C is equal to? Opposite side is 1, adjacent side is root of n square minus 1, right? So opposite side is 1, adjacent side is root of n square minus 1, so tan C is equal to R by D, that is equal to 1 divided by root of n square minus 1. So from here, what is R is equal to? D divided by root of n square minus 1. This is the expression for the radius of the circle of illuminance. The radius of circle of illuminance is given by R is equal to D divided by root of n square minus 1. The question, what is the area of the circle of illuminance? Area. Area of the circle of illuminance is pi R square. That is equal to pi D square divided by n square minus 1. The area of the circle of illuminance is, area of the circle of illuminance is pi D square divided by n square minus 1. So these two formulae are very important in the board exam point of view. Based on this one, you have to do exercise question 9.5. Exercise question 9.5 from NCERT textbook. You have to do by means of this formula. Exercise question 9.5. Okay, now let me tell you. Take the case 1. For water, n is equal to 4 by 3. In that situation, let me tell you, sin C is equal to 3 by 4, that is 1 by n, or C is equal to 48.75 degree. So critical angle for water is 48.75 degree. Now the thing we are going to study, find out is the radius of the circle of illuminance. Here we can see that D divided by root of, so n is 4 by 3, n square, 4 square by 3 square, 16 by 9 minus 1. 16 by 9 minus 1, right? That is equal to D divided by root of 16 minus 9 into root of 9, that is 3. I have taken this. Okay, I will do it in the next step. 16 divided by 9, 16 minus 9 divided by 9. So R is equal to D divided by 16 minus 9 is 7, root of 7 into this 9 I will take to the numerator. So this is the answer. So I can finally conclude this is equal to, the radius of the circle of illuminance is 3D divided by root 7. So this is for water. The radius of the circle of illuminance is 3d by root 7 for water. Now the question, what is going to be the area? Okay, we'll take here. Area of circle of illuminance for water. We have the formula pi r square. So r I got, so r square becomes 9 pi d square divided by 7. Now one thing I will say is that 9 pi is approximately 28. 28 by 7. So this answer is approximately 4 d square. Here what is d? D stands for depth. D stands for the depth of the object from the surface. D is the depth of the object from the surface. So area is equal to pi r square, that is 9 pi d square divided by 7, which is approximately 4 d square. Now we will take the same for glass. For glass, second case is glass. These are the two cases that generally comes in problem. Refractive index is equal to 3 by 2. Now radius r is equal to d divided by root of 3 by 2 in the square. What is the square of 3 by 2? 9 by 4 minus 1. So d divided by 9 by 4 minus 1 is root of 5 by 4. This is equal to 2d divided by root 5. So radius of the circle of illuminance is 2d divided by root 5. Now what is the area of the circle of illuminance? Pi r square, that is equal to 4 pi d square divided by root 5 square 5. So area of the circle of illuminance, 4 pi is 12.5, this is approximately equal to 2.5 d square. Now hereafter if you get a problem like this, directly you can solve it. So area of the circle of illuminance is given by this expression. This is the expression for area of circle of illuminance, this is the expression for the radius of the circle of illuminance. I hope this much is absolutely clear to you. So in the next class, we will discuss about optic fiber cables and the condition of total internal reflection. Thank you.